Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to HorizonHobby.com's New and Hot. This is your source for the newest information out there in the world of RC. I am Gary Katzer, site content specialist here for HorizonHobby.com. We have a lot of news this week, so we're going to get right to it. First of all, from eFlight, they have what they're calling the Hawker Hurricane. And don't make the mistake, it's not a Spitfire, it's not a Sea Fury, it's a Hawker Hurricane. There are two different versions of this that the eFlight team has put together for you. The first is a bind and fly, that is EFL 2980, and those are going to be $349.99. The other one is going to be a plug-and-play version, and that is EFL 2975, and that is going to be $279.99. These are absolutely gorgeous planes if you've had a chance to take a look at them. And I can understand why someone earlier today called it a Spitfire. It looks very similar to the livery that we had on the older Park Zone Spitfire. But don't be mistaken. This isn't a Park Zone plane. This is full-bred eFlight. That means it's going to have excellent electronics. It's going to have a larger overall wingspan and all. We're going to get into that in just a moment. It is a full Z-foam design that you have on this airplane. So it's robust and durable, very similar to what you'll find on the Carbon Z-Yak, but it's not a Carbon Z design. This is just Z-foam, but the foam density is a little bit, well, it's a little bit denser foam than what you would normally have. I've been told that it has a very similar look and feel to what the Habu has. So if you're familiar with that, it's kind of what this looks like here. It's going to use a 25 size brushless motor, and it's a 1000 kV rating on there. They've gone all out too with the electronics in this package. It includes an eFlight 60 amp speed controller, a 3S 3200 milliamp 30C LiPo battery, and you don't have to install flaps. They come installed for you. There are 6 metal geared servos that come pre-installed in this plane for you, so they've taken the extra step of doing that for you. Now, in addition to that, it does come with fixed landing gear out of the box. You can go ahead and install the optional retracts if you'd like. That's part number EFLG200, and you can go ahead and add those if you are looking for that extra little bit of scale realism on your Warbird for you there too. It does include a balancing charger to go ahead and charge that 3S 3200 milliamp 30C LiPo for you. And just to kind of give you guys an idea of the size of this plane, the Park Zone T28, possibly the most popular Warbird that Park Zone has ever come out with, you're looking at a 44 inch wingspan and 36 inch length. This thing is massive. This is a 52-inch wingspan, and it's 42 inches long, so considerably larger there. Look for that soon, and we're going to try to get our hands on one of those. Have John Redmond go ahead and do a preview of it, try to get on the show for you guys next week. On the surface side, I do have some neat information for you guys, too. If you guys are familiar with Extreme Racing, they make some really nice carbon fiber and option parts out there for a number of different vehicles. They've just announced this week some new additional parts out there for a lot of the electric vehicles, specifically the Ruckus. Things like battery stair apps I've seen, shock towers. Go ahead and check them out over on HorizonHobby.com. J Concepts has also come out this week with a number of new pre-mount tires, more leaning towards like the two-wheel drive buggy class, but there's some other interesting compounds and tread patterns here. Again, for the two-wheel drive buggy class, they're doing pre-mounted blue barcodes, green double Ds, green groovy front tires, and goosebumps, all for the two-wheel drive. So it'll fit the XXX CR. It'll fit the B4 and the B44 in the rear. And this is the one that I thought that was kind of neat. They're coming out with a 1/16 scale set of pre-mounted goosebumps specifically for you guys out there who have the 1/16 scale Revos out there. So that'll be pretty cool if you're looking for more traction out there. We do have two new products here in the studio today. First is the new Sidewinder V2 from Castle Creations. And there's a couple different ways that this will come out of the box. You can get it as just the speed controller or the speed controller bundled with the motor itself. And they're promising that this should have about 40% more power than the original Sidewinder motor. It's designed specifically for 1/10 scale vehicles. So if you're looking for like the 4x4 short course trucks or for the A-scale electric buggies, not quite up to that. But if you're looking for a stadium truck, a two-wheel drive short course truck, things along those lines, this will work just fine. It is also fully compatible with their CastleLink software too, so you can go ahead and tweak and tune the programming as you see fit. Comes pre-wired with bullet-style connectors on the speed controller and then the battery connector. That's left up to you. The motors themselves also have the bullet plugs on the other end, and the wires are color-coded to get you up and running a little bit quicker. Now, there are four different ways you can get this. If you just need a new speed controller and you already have the motors, you can get just the Sidewinder V2 Sport Speed Controller. That is CSESDWSV2, and those are $67.99. You can also get them bundled with one of three different motors. There is a 4600 kV, 5700, and 6900 kV motor, and those motor and speed controller, $99.99. Pretty sweet deal when you're looking at it. Part numbers on those, whatever kV rating you want, either the 4600, 5700, or 6900, just tack that on to the end of the CSESDWSV2 part number, and that'll get you lined up with what you need there. Finally, this week we have, and we talked about this last week, this is the AR drone from Parrot, and this thing is pretty sweet. It comes out of the box as you see it here, and there's actually two different shrouds, I'll call it, that you can either put on it. The one that you see here, this is designed for outdoor flight, and they also have this setup here. And this is designed for if you're just learning to fly it or for flying indoors. What's really cool about the AR drone is how you control it. You don't use a traditional transmitter. You don't use a 2.4 gigahertz transmitter. It actually works off of the Wi-Fi system built into an iPod Touch, an iPhone, or an iPad, all from Apple. And what you do basically with any of these, or with that setup, is you go ahead and you download the free app from their store, install it on your device, and then it'll walk you through all the basic setup things that you need to go ahead and fly this. Now, what's neat about this is, sure, you can use the gyroscope in your device to go ahead and fly this, but it also offers a level of augmented reality that we haven't seen before in RC like this. If you look in the nose here, there's a camera here, and there's another camera on the bottom side as well. And basically what these do is they beam those pictures to your device, to your iPod Touch, your iPhone, or your iPad. And you can actually fly this without ever looking directly at it. You can fly it by simply looking at your device. Again, like I mentioned, the flight application is free. There's a bunch of other applications out there for this that you can do, like capture the flag or aerial dogfighting, stuff like that. If you want, you can also go ahead. There are third-party apps that will allow you to record the video from your flights too. And these are $299.99 right now, and part number is PTAPF720000. And don't call it a helicopter, it's a quadricopter. It uses four brushless motors, one on each rotor blade. It also has four separate electronic speed controllers, one for each motor, to really help provide that extra control and precision that you're going to want in the air. Now, it comes out of the box as you see it here. It also comes with the other ring that you saw a little bit earlier. It also includes a hard-cased 1,000 milliamp 10C LiPo battery. So good on them for using LiPo and not going with a nickel metal hydride or an ICAD. So you get lightweight battery and excellent performance on here. Flight time, about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how you fly it. And it's completely repairable. It's very durable, too. I mean, the fact that I can bend the props like this, or the rotor blades like this, just shows that it's designed to take a beating. It does use our regular type of foam that we use here in the hobby grade industry, so you can go ahead and use FoamSafe CA to repair it. They even suggest just using servo tape, depending on how dramatic the damage may be. Full line of option parts and repair parts will be available too. So if you do happen to damage it, and they're pretty tough, you can go ahead and get them fixed for you too. As far as range, you don't need, first of all, you don't need to be connected to your home Wi-Fi. It creates its own ad hoc type network. So it'll create a connection between the drone and iPod Touch, your iPad, or your iPhone. So it'll go ahead and create your own Wi-Fi network between this and your device itself, and you don't need anything else around. So if you're out in the country, out on a farm, I've seen videos, guys flying these on golf courses, things along those lines, where you don't need to have a Wi-Fi network available to you. It does everything in and of itself. Has got these neat little sensors underneath too to kind of help judge how high off the ground, and just make it a really very easy for, I mean, we're RC guys here. We're going to kind of have an idea before we even pick up the controls how to fly this. This makes it easier for someone who may never have been involved in the RC hobby. So pretty cool there. And these are available now on the HorizonHobby.com website. Speaking of which, one last thing before we go here today is the DX3R Pro. Just announced 2 weeks ago, they're available. Go ahead. You can order them now, and we'll have them to you in the very near future. Very exciting stuff here. If you do have any comments or questions about anything that you've seen here today or anything RC in general, please feel free to email us, editors@horizonrc.com. You can also tweet us any of your questions at horizon_hobby. I'm on there at @RCGaryK. You may notice a little bit of a different look to this week's show. We are trying to go ahead and improve the video as we go along. You know, we do hear you guys. We are trying the best that we can. There are limits that we're running into in regards to Ustream and the quality of the video. We're trying to make the best out of what we have, and we're going to make it even better as we go on into the future. So trust me, your voices are being heard. We will upload the standard definition and the higher definition videos like what we have been doing. So keep an eye out. Friday morning, we'll have the higher res version up there for you. We're going to go to the live chat. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask them there.